Good afternoon. Okay, I hope you can see the presentation, right? You can see your experiment that we are going to do today. Okay, so basically we are doing the verification of Thevenin's theorem today, right? And this was already in your I already covered this Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem and superposition theorem in basic electrical, right? So quickly I will recapitulate this Thevenin's theorem and its what are the main points, then we will directly go to the practical part. Okay, is that clear?
Yes sir.
Okay, fine. So you can see this is the Thevenin's theorem circuit. If this one is the circuit, then A, B is your load. And as per Thevenin's theorem, first we need to omit that load. We need to remove that load, right? And we have to see from that load terminal that two things you need to calculate. First one is the open circuit voltage that we generally call VOC and the Thevenin equivalent resistance. And during that Thevenin equivalent resistance calculation, voltage sources will be done what? Voltage
short circuit.
Short circuited, and current sources will be
open
circuited. Good. So this is your today's circuit. Okay, this is your circuit. This one you need to draw in your copy. Okay, this portion. Okay, so here you can see that 12 volt is our input, right? And this is the DC voltage. Remember, this is the DC voltage. Okay, now this 1 and 2, this point is open right now. We will close that so that the current will flow with the patch cord. Okay, then in series 220E, that means e to the power 0. So here the resistance is 220 ohm. Clear? Next, 562 ohm, here 200 ohm, 511 ohm, 470 ohm. Clear? Then here is your RL, that means your load terminal. Okay, so from here you need to calculate the Thevenin voltage, that means your open circuit voltage across this 3 and 5 using the multimeter. Clear? Then we will short circuit this 2 and the ground, and then from seeing this terminal we will calculate the Thevenin resistance, Thevenin equivalent resistance, that is RTH. Okay, now there is one knob here. This is the knob using which we can regulate the load resistance. Okay, now load resistance you can see, Thevenin equivalent resistance you were calculated using the multimeter, and then VTH also you have. Clear? So that you can form a particular voltage, the Thevenin equivalent resistance and the load circuit, and connect that in series. So you can calculate the load current that will flow through the RL. That is the main concept of Thevenin's theorem. Okay. Now, what apparatus we are going to use? We are going to use the network trainer kit. Okay. Its range is plus minus 5 volt to plus minus 12 volt analog board of quantity 1. Power supply will be given here, 12 volt, that is obviously DC. Multimeter we are going to use, and 2 mm patch cords as much as we need. Okay. So first, all of you draw this circuit, this portion only. Okay. This portion only. Just draw that in your copy. Otherwise, you cannot understand. Okay. Quickly draw that in your copy. I am giving you some time. Okay, so have you drawn it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next you are going to write this observation table. Okay, this is your result table, this one. Now write down all this, all the table. Okay, and we are going to take the RL value in between 0 to 1000 ohm. That means 0 to 1 kilo ohm, we are going to take any one value as per our need. Okay, so first of all, draw this table. Okay, write down this table in your copy. Then we will directly shift to the practical part. Have you written that in your copy? Have you written the parameters and practical value this table? I'm not getting any response whether you have completed the writing or not.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Then I just stopped the screen sharing and directly we are switching to the practical part. Okay. Okay, check. Is the screen visible right now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Here you see one box. Okay. This one is DC, fixed DC power supply. Okay. Here we get plus minus 12 volt DC source and plus minus 5 volt DC source. Here there are some terminals. These two are plus 12 and these two are plus minus 12. These two are plus 5, these two are minus 5 terminals, okay? And here we see two ground. This one is power switch, on-off switch, okay? This one is, this box is DC power supply, fixed DC power supply, okay? This, what is connected to the board, here? It is, board is going to the DC source. Next week, this one is, network kit, okay. Thevenin's theorem and maximum power transfer theorem network kit, okay. Its maker's name is Scientech AB82 model, okay. In this circuit diagram, here you see there are some resistances here, R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, okay. Below of R1 is 220 E, E stands for ohm, okay. That means value of R1 is 220 ohm, R2 value of R2 is 200 ohm, R3 is 470 ohm, R4 is 562 ohm, and R5 is 511 ohm, okay. And here we see one load resistance, we see one arrow, that means it is variable resistance, okay. That means it maximum resistance we will get 1 kilo ohm, okay. It is up to 0 to 1000 ohm, okay. That means maximum 1 kilo ohm, okay. We see one knob, this knob, we can vary the load resistance by this knob. We can either increase or decrease, okay. In this circuit diagram, we also see source voltage that is 12 volt plus 12 volt. This one, these three are same terminal, plus 12 volt terminal. Okay. If we connect to DC source to plus 12 volt, then this two will be sorted and this two will be sorted. Okay. And we may connect directly to the two terminal. Plus 12 volt will be connected directly to the two terminal. Okay. And here we see some ground. This three are ground. Okay. So we take either this one or this one or this one. Okay. We also may connect directly to the this terminal. Okay. So at first, next, here you see some this one is patch cord, okay. By this patch cord we will connect, okay. And you see one multimeter. By the multimeter we can measure voltage, resistance, and current, etc. Okay. Here in this multimeter there are two terminals. One is common, another is voltage, resistance, or milliampere. Okay. So these two multimeter has two terminals. Okay. And here in this multimeter for voltage range there are two voltage range. One is for DC and another is for AC. Here we see one V and then one straight line. That means it is DC. When we will measure DC, then this is this will be set at this portion. No? Okay. And here we see one V and one wave symbol. That means it is AC. Okay, when you need to measure AC voltage, then you should select this here. Okay, so now at first we have to find out VTH, that is Thevenin voltage. So students, have any idea how to find out the DC voltage from this circuit diagram, from this network kit? Which two terminals voltage is given as the VTH of the circuit? Have any idea? So, student, have a give response. Have any idea? Hello, student. Am I audible to you? Are you all sleeping now?
Sir, by removing the load resistance.
By the multimeter, how we measure the Thevenin's voltage from the circuit? I'm just asking you the find out the voltage, okay? So So here we see three terminal and six terminal, okay? So multimeter terminal is connected to these two terminal, this multimeter gives us VTH, okay? So next we will complete the circuit. So plus 12 volt will be connected to the plus 12 volt two terminal, okay? And one ground is connected to the ground. Circuit is completed. Okay. Next, you on the system. Here we set 20 volt DC. If you will note down VTH, it is 5.04. Okay.
Have you noted?
Yes, sir.
These are the what readings we will provide you. These are the all practical value. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And theoretical value you will calculate at your home, okay?
Okay, sir.
Practical values, okay? This is the value of VTH, that is 5.04, okay? Next, we will find out RTH, okay? So find out RTH, that is resistance, there is no need to give supply, okay? So you have the system? We just... sorted these two terminal to two terminal and ground. Okay, we just sort these two terminal. Okay, and next we have to find out the resistance by these two terminal. Okay, and you say that we said in multimeter 20 kilo ohm, 2 kilo ohm. Okay, so now we will find out the RTH. Okay. Point six eight two kilo ohm. That means 682 ohm. Everybody note down this reading. Value of RTH is equal to 0.68 kilo ohm. That means 682 ohm. 682 ohm. Okay. 0.682 kilo ohm. It is noted, everybody.
Yes, sir.
Next, we will find out RL. Okay, so here we see from the circuit we see RL. So 4 and 5, these two terminal resistance is called RL. Okay, so what is the value of RL? One is connected, one terminal is connected to the 4 and one is 5. Okay.
Okay, so this is your load resistance, that is 0.849 kilo ohm, that means 849 ohm. Okay, so now you have in your hand the VTH value, that is your VOC, RTH value, that is Thevenin equivalent resistance value, and the load resistance. Okay, now tell me what is the load current that will flow through the load resistance. Calculate it and say what is the value of the load current. We are going to take only one reading here. Did anyone calculate?
Sir, 0.003.
Right, 0.00328. That means 3.2 milliampere approx, right?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So all these readings that you are getting here, these are the practical values. Okay, so now we are putting the multimeter into off mode, right? So now it's your work to do that. Here RTH, VTH, and based on that practical value, IL, you have calculated as almost 3 point something milliampere. Okay, so circuit you have now. So this, now you have to calculate the theoretical value and check what is the difference. Okay. And this while calculating the theoretical value, the whole calculation you have to show in copy, in lab copy. Okay, the whole calculation you have to show while doing the theoretical value. Is that clear, or do you have any confusion? Then you may ask.
Sir, lab copy matlab A4 page mein na?
Yes, obviously.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so practical value you have now, theoretical value you have to calculate, and all the calculation you have to show. Okay, then you have to check whether there is a particular difference you are getting or not. So now pay attention, we are going to take your attendance.
Okay, sir.
Okay, roll number 1.
Yes, sir.
Roll number 2.
Present, sir.
Okay, roll number one, Kunal Kesh present. Two, Soumya Banerjee present. Abhijit Shaw.
Present, sir.
Okay, Shubham Chaudhary.
Present, sir.
Sneha Sarkar. Sneha Sarkar. Absent. Rajdeep Majhi.
Present, sir.
Udayan Chaudhary. Udayan Chaudhary. Absent. Aritra Bose. Aritra Bose. Absent. Abhishek Chaudhary.
Present, sir.
Swati Das.
Present, sir.
Kanchan Sarkar.
Present, sir.
Okay, Swati Das, are you present?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, Kanchan Sarkar. Also
yes,
present.
Sir.
Yes, Arijit Bandyopadhyay.
Present, sir.
Tamanna Parveen. Tamanna Parveen.
Present, sir.
Okay, present. Anish Awad.
Present, sir.
Chanchal Mandal.
Present, sir.
Bikram Kumar Pandit.
Present, sir.
Kaushik Sadhu.
Present, sir.
Rohit Mukherjee.
Present, sir.
Subhadip Majhi.
Present, sir.
Adrita Pathak. Absent. Saurabh Kumar. Absent. Joy Chakraborty. Joy Chakraborty.
Present.
Joy Chakraborty.
Sir, he is present.
Why isn't he responding then?
Sir, he is writing chat box.
Okay, Joy Chakraborty present. Okay, Udayan Chaudhary also present. Udayan Chaudhary also present. Okay, Shilpa Prasad.
Present, sir.
Okay. Shubham Ghosh.
Present, sir.
Nidhi Kumari. Nidhi Kumari.
Present, sir.
Okay. Pranay Gupta. Vishnu Sharma.
Present, sir.
Sumit Mihiracharjo.
Present, sir.
Nandini Paul.
Present, sir.
Sheila Bhattacharya. Sheila Bhattacharya.
Present, sir. Sheila is present.
Okay. Manav Bhattacharya.
Yes, sir.
Kazi Arbaz Hussain. Kazi Arbaz Hussain. Absent. Okay, so thank you everyone to join the class. Thank you very much. I am ending the meeting.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Sir, ekhan theke amake eta nite hobe. Hello. Huh?